Krishna is not visible, God is not visible, but He is so kind that He has come before you, visible to your material eyes. Krishna is not visible within this material world, material eyes. Just like Krishna's part and parcel, we are Krishna's part and parcel, all living entities, but we do not see each other. You cannot see me, I do not see you. No, I see you. You see my body. Then, when the soul is gone from the body, why you are crying? My father is gone. Why father is gone? Father is lying here. Then what you have seen? You have seen the dead body of your father, not your father. If you cannot see the particle of Krishna, the soul, how you can see Krishna? Therefore, Shastra say, Navaved Grahyam Indriyam, this blunt material eyes. He cannot see Krishna or cannot hear Krishna's name, Namadi. Nam means name. Nam means name, form, quality, pastime. These things cannot be understood by your material blunt eyes or senses. But they are purified. Sevanamukhi, Ijuvavu. If they are purified by process of devotional service, you can see Krishna all time and everywhere. But for ordinary person, alaksham, not visible. Krishna is everywhere. God is everywhere. Annantarastham paramanachayantarastham. So alaksham sarvabhutanam. Although Krishna is outside and inside, both, still we cannot see Krishna unless we have got the eyes to see Krishna. So this Krishna consciousness moment is to open the eyes, how to see Krishna. And if you can see Krishna, antat bahir, then your life is success. Therefore, Shastra says that antat bahir jadi Krishna, tamasata tatthi, nantat bahir jadi vari, sarvasata tatthi. Everyone is trying to become perfect. But the perfection means when one can see Krishna within and without. That is perfect.